Let's start with a quarter circle with the radius of 10. Then on the left radius we will put the point which divides this radius into two identical segments. Then we will put another point on the bottom right corner of our quarter circle and one point on the arc of quarter circle in such a way so that if we connect all three points we will get this inscribed right triangle. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this red right inscribed triangle? If you want to try to answer this question for yourself, this would be a great time to pause the video and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one. So, I will offer you three different geometric methods to solve this problem. In first method, we will use the Ptolemy's theorem, and this is by far my favorite method. So we will start by labeling the vertices of our triangle as A, B, and C. We will also label the center of our quarter circle as O. Then, let's have a look at the quadrilateral OBCA. You can see that two angles of this quadrilateral, the angle at the point O and the angle at the point C, are both 90 degree angles. So now let's remind ourselves about one really interesting property of quadrilateral, which states that a cyclic quadrilateral has opposite angles that sum 180 degrees. So, if we add two of our opposite angles O and C, we will get 180 degrees. This means that our quadrilateral is actually a cyclic quadrilateral. So, we can actually circumscribe a circle around this quadrilateral. This is important because we want to use the Ptolemy's theorem. And Ptolemy's theorem is related to cyclic quadrilateral and its diagonals. It states that if quadrilateral is cyclic, then the product of the lengths of its diagonals is equal to the sum of the products of the lengths of the pairs of opposite sides. So, if we label the vertices on our quadrilateral to the right exactly the same way as the quadrilateral to the left, you can see that we have the exact same situation. So, we will use this formula. We can say that the product of the diagonals OC and AB is equal to the sum of the products of the opposite sides of our quadrilateral. So, we will use this formula, but first we need to find all the values that we need. We can easily find the length OA since it is equal to the half of the radius, that is 5. Now, I will label the side BC as A and AC as B for better understanding. Then, let's take a look at the right triangle OBA. And we can use the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle. And if we substitute our values and work through this, we will get that AB squared is equal to 125, which nicely simplifies to 5 square root of 5. So, we have one diagonal. Now, let's have a look at the radius OB. We can rotate this radius up until the point C. And you can see that OC will also have the value of 10. Now, we are going to substitute our values into Ptolemy's formula. And we will get the following. We can simplify by dividing everything with 5, and finally, we will get that A is equal to 10 square root of 5 minus 2B. So, this is our first equation. Let's find another one. Let's have a look at our wanted red triangle ABC. We can use the Pythagorean theorem on this one as well. So we can say that the leg CB squared is equal to the hypotenuse AB squared minus the leg AC squared. We will substitute our values, get everything to the square, and we will get that A squared is equal to 125 minus B squared. Now we can just solve this system of equations to get A and B. We will first substitute the value of A into our second equation and get the following. Then we will expand by using the square of binomial and work through this. Finally, we will divide each term with 5, and we will get this really nice quadratic equation. So, we have a multiple ways to solve this quadratic equation, but for this video, I will choose the quadratic formula. Just to remind you, if we have quadratic equation in a form of ax squared plus bx plus c that is equal to 0, we can use the following quadratic formula, where a, b, and c are constants. In our case, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 8 square root of 5, and c is equal to 75. So, we're just going to substitute those values into our quadratic formula. And we will simplify this, and finally we will get two possible solutions, that b is equal to 3 square root of 5, or 5 square root of 5. But which one is valid? Well, you can actually notice that the hypotenuse of our triangle is equal to 5 square root of 5. So this actually means that the leg cannot have the same length as hypotenuse. So this one is not the valid solution. So the only possible solution for us is that b is equal to 3 square root of 5. Now, we're going to replace this value into our previous equation for a. We will work through this and get that a is equal to 4 square root of 5. Now, it's pretty simple to find the area of the red triangle. Since it is the right triangle, its area will be equal to 1/2 of the product of its legs. So, we're just going to substitute the values for a and b, simplify it, and get that the area of our red triangle is equal to 30 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method in which we will use the triangle similarity. This method, we are going to start by labeling the vertices of our triangle the same way as in the previous method. I'm going to label the center the same way as O, and I'm going to label the legs as A and B as in the previous method. Now we're going to think outside the box. We're going to extend our quarter circle so that it forms a half circle. Then we're going to extend the line AC. And if we do this, this line will end up at the end of the diameter of our half circle. And we will label this point as D. But how do we know that the extension of the line AC will go to the point D? Well, actually, we know this by using the inscribed angle theorem. This theorem states that if we have the inscribed angle inside the circle, and let's label it as theta, this angle is half of the central angle 2 theta that intercepts the same arc on the circle. So, if we label the sketch on the right the same way as the sketch on the left, you can clearly see that theta is corresponding to the angle at the point C, which is 90 degree angle. And the angle of 2 theta corresponds to the angle at the point O, which is equal to 180 degrees, which is exactly twice as the angle C. So, this means that the extension of the line AC will end up to the end of the diameter of our half circle. Alright, so now let's continue by looking at the right triangle DOA. We can see that OD is equal to the radius of the circle, so its length must be equal to 10, and as we said earlier, OA is half of the radius, so its length is equal to 5. Now, let's isolate this right triangle DOA. Then, let's have a look at the right triangle OBA. In previous method, we used the Pythagorean theorem to find the hypotenuse AB. So, I'm not going to do this all over again, but I will leave you the calculation if you want to check this one out. Then, let's notice that the triangle DOA is actually congruent to the triangle AOB, since both of them have two identical legs, and both of them are right triangles. So that means that the length DA is also equal to 5 square root of 5. Now let's have a look at the big right triangle DBC. and let's isolate this triangle. You can clearly see that the hypotenuse DB is actually equal to the diameter of our half circle, so it is equal to 20. And we have labeled the side BC as A. Now we can notice that the angle at the point D for those two triangles is actually the same. So, since those two triangles have two congruent angles, this means that those two triangles are similar. So we can use the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between their hypotenuse is equal to the relation between their legs. And of course, we will substitute our values. Now, we will just cross-multiply this and get the following. We can now simplify by dividing both sides with 5, and we will get that A is equal to 20 over square root of 5, which actually really nicely simplifies to 4 square root of 5. Alright, so now we will again use the Pythagorean theorem for our wanted red triangle ABC. We can say that B squared is equal to 5 square root of 5 squared minus A squared. And we can substitute the value of A into this equation and get the following. Now we will put everything to the square and find that B square is equal to 45, which actually means that B is equal to 3 square root of 5. Now we can simply find the area of this right triangle as in the first method. We will substitute the values for A and B and finally get that the area of our red triangle is equal to 30 squared units, and this is again our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the third and the final method, the intersecting chord theorem. So, I'm going to start this method by labeling the vertices, the legs, and I'm going to label the center the same way as O as in our two previous methods. But this time, I'm going to form a full circle from our quarter circle. Then, I will extend both radius to form horizontal and vertical diameter, just as shown in the sketch. Then, I will extend the line AC, which we already proven in our second method that it goes to the point D. And finally, let's label both intersections with our vertical diameter as E and F. Alright, so we know that the line OA has the length of 5, since it is the half of the radius. We also know that AD is equal to 5 square root of 5, as well as AB, because we already calculated those values in our previous methods. Then, we can see that the line EA is also half of the radius, so it must be equal to 5, and OF is equal to the radius, so it must have the length of 10. Now, from this sketch, we can use the intersecting chord theorem, which states when two chords of a circle intersects within a circle, the product of the segments of one chord is equal to the product of the segments of the other chord. So again, I will label the sketch on the right the same as the sketch on the left, and let's clear our image a little bit just to see this one better. Now you can see that we have identical situation. So if we substitute our values from the sketch, we will get the following. Now it's pretty easy for us to find the length B. We can simplify this and finally get that B is equal to 15 over square root of 5, which actually simplifies to 3 square root of 5. Then, you guessed it, we will use the Pythagorean theorem for our red triangle ABC once again. But this time we will substitute the value of B and get the following. We will put everything to the square and get that A squared is equal to 80, which actually simplifies to 4 square root of 5. And now it's again pretty simple to find the area of our red triangle as the half of the product of its legs. We're just going to substitute the values for A and B once again and work through this to finally get that the area of our red triangle is equal to 30 squared units, and again, we have our solution. Well, I hope you all enjoyed this interesting problem. If you did, leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. It really means a lot. And if you found another way to solve this problem, write it down in the comment section as you always do. And until next time, as always, see you all and take care.